Hello, everybody. We are talking via Skype with Davide Biocchi, trader from Directa. Hello, Davide.
Hello, how are you doing?
Very well, how are you?
Doing good, thank you.
Davide, it was a very fascinating week if we look at the stock markets. If you look at the all-time high at S&P, at Dow Jones, what can you say about it?
Well, that during this week we have seen how much the stocks market are really strong, not only in US, but also in Europe. Imagine that we supposed for a long time that this coronavirus problem could impact the market. And in fact, it will happen later when, let me say, we will see the quarterly GDP, especially from China. So we will see probably some bad results for some companies that have business or run business in China, okay? But as I explained so many times, this will impact maybe one or two quarter, let me say, with the revenues, but the values of the companies will remain the same, okay? So in a certain way, we can see later. I don't know when it will end. I mean, when this pandemic situation will find an end. But after that, we can see a recovery in the economy. So I think that it would be something like a V formation, okay? And this is what the markets bet on. So this week, the situation completely changed. We are again in a risk-on environment. When you have a risk-on environment, people normally sell gold, exit the bonds, and buy stocks or buy, let me say, growing countries, okay, generally. And this is what we have seen. We have seen the very good performance, weekly performance of the S&P 500 that we can see here, and exactly posting new historical maximum, overtaking the previous one that was the resistance here. And then we have seen also that the market have a rebound exactly connected to the previous minimums that we had in January when there was the crisis with the Iran. So the situation is really nice. I hope that this week we can end over this resistance because it will be the meaning will be very important, especially also for Italy. If you are interested, I can show you why.
Yeah, of course, of course.
So in Italy, we have a very important situation that is that through the years, we never were able to overtake some prices. It's more than 11 years that we were not able to overtake this kind of prices that we have seen here. Imagine these are previous years. As you can see, we were never able to overtake this price, then here again, and then here again. And it is from since 2009, so 11 years, that every time that we arrive here, the market comes back. So what was happening right now was that several days, the market was not able to overtake the price, as I can show you here in details. But right now, 2 days ago, the situation completely changed. This is a daily chart. And as you can see here, we were able to overtake the previous maximum, and then we have also this one. So the situation is really interesting right now, and if we will close, if this week we land over this price, we can discuss about a 20 years trend inversion. Because imagine that the Italian market posted their historical maximum the 6th of March of the year 2000. So it was 20 years ago. So it's something that can be very relevant in the future. And this situation is very similar also for the Spanish market that within the last days was overtaking a very important resistance.
This week make bulls very happy. And I think also very happy after this week is Elon Musk.
Why not?
Yeah, exactly. We saw what happened to Tesla. What can you say about it?
Well, Tesla is a very interesting story. Imagine that there was a moment last year in which maybe someone could even think that that the company could be bought maybe from some other car maker in the world, because the situation was not so good. Imagine when the price went under 200, it was last June, I don't know if you remember, and the situation completely changed. If you remember, there was also a lot of talks about Elon Musk. He said that maybe the company could be bought, maybe not. He was also fined by the SEC, the securities, let me say, the authority, the US authority, okay? Uh-huh. And so the situation went through like this, but recently we have the overtaking of this price that is very close to $370, and the stocks completely jumped, skyrocket to the high, okay, and the price more than double in the month of January, so that it was hit a maximum between $900 and $1,000 per share, and then the price came a little bit back, but I think that the shareholders are really very happy, even if the week will not end at the top, okay?
Yeah, Davide, you're a trader with a lot of experience. If you, you are watching this chart, and do you see some bubbles, some pump and dump? What can you say about it? Because I'm just wondering, is it possibly Tesla to go for about 1,000 or maybe more? Because I'm looking at this and I see some similarities on the chart, only looking at the technicalities. I'm looking at the similars to the Bitcoin in 2017.
Okay, what is really relevant in the market is to understand if the prices, the price earning, the let me say the ratio are correct, okay? And in this case, we could say that especially due to the expectation, we have higher expectation connected to revenues of the companies, I mean US companies, obviously, connected to the signature of the agreement that went on through Donald Trump and the Chinese, okay? So in this case, this agreement can boost really also the profits of the US companies. And so there are some ideas that tells us that the market can find, let me say, this thing to be a good one, okay? But on the other side, I'm a little bit worried because I see on charts that the price went on really too much in a certain way, especially here, as you can see. Imagine that here with Tesla we have 2-3 days that did the real final skyrocket, okay, and then the market came down because it was just a very basic news to let people go and take profit on the stock. So the situation that really worries me is the one connected to the crude oil, because if the crude oil will go under 50, and we are very close to 50 in this moment, if the crude oil will go under 50, as you can see here, the price will probably slip down to 43 or something like that. I expect it, because all the activity on options will push the, let me say, main actors in this market to sell the commodity. So I expect a sell-off under 50. I hope it will not happen, but during this week we already have a test of the support. So that's why I'm worried. I'm not worried about the stocks market, because we have to stay in the trend. Uh-huh. And we need to be ready to exit if something is going not in the wrong way, I mean, not in the right side. But until the moment it will happen something like that, we need to stay in the market. Maybe we are not so happy with charts, but we need to buy, continue buying, okay? On the other side, we need to monitor really the crude oil, because it's very important. On the other side, I think that it could be very interesting to watch also the gold, because if the gold will overtake the price of 1,610, in this case, I think that we are more, let me say, more closer to a sell-off on the stock market, okay?
Okay, so just at this final, I would like to, if I would be grateful if you could show us a chart of DAX, and what can you say about it, about this German German index? So you see similarity to the S&P 500, or maybe Europe is going worse?
I think it's not, because as you can see, I showed you that the US indices already overtake the previous resistance. We have seen something similar also in the Italian index. But if you look at the DAX, you can see that they are very close to this resistance, but they not yet overtake it. So the breakout is not yet a reality here because of the fact that they have problems with the manufacture. And this is a complicated situation, especially because they do not expect, I mean, if we look at the PMI, the Purchasing Manager Index, they do not expect even if the situation is now a little bit better than before, they do not expect big changes in short term. So I think that to help the German index to recover, some solutions taken by the politicians that must create some stimulus for the economy must arrive. Otherwise, we will see this index having more problems in the future because they have really several problems with the manufacturer production. So this is a little bit different, okay? But in general, the European economy can be impacted also by the agreement that is yet to be done with the UK after the Brexit. And also imagine this, there was a signature of an agreement that China needs to buy more and more from US. And I'm supposing that they did not buy because they simply have to. They will buy what they need. And maybe they will have to buy from US something that they are already buying from Europe. So I can see that potentially, especially Germany and all these countries that exports a lot of things to China, they can be impacted by the agreement that the Chinese did with the US. Okay?
Okay, okay. Davide, you're looking forward to the next week?
Oh yes. And don't worry also that today, 2:30, we will have a payrolls. Mm-hmm. And the payrolls are really important because they will tell us the present status, let me say, of the US economy. So unemployment and payrolls are one of the most relevant scheduled macroeconomic data of the month.
Okay, okay. Davide, thank you very much for this conversation. My guest and yours was Davide Biocchi, trader from Directa.
Ciao, ciao. See you soon.
Ciao, ciao. Thank you.